RNA-Seq FASTQ processing on Windows 10 requires activating WSL and Ubuntu. Otherwise, you cannot go to the next step. Let's activate WSL. Open the Apps and Features setting panel. Click Programs and Features at the right top corner. If you don't see it, expand the panel to display it. Click Turn Windows Features On or Off on the left side. Check on the Windows Subsystem for Linux. Wait until the Windows preparing, and restart the computer. Search Ubuntu at the Microsoft App Store. Select Ubuntu and install it. Launch Ubuntu, and set the username and password for the Linux system. Close the Ubuntu panel, and launch the Subio platform. Open the Import Samples wizard and select the RNA-Seq FASTQ option. You can click the Next button this time. Click the link at the FASTP executable section. Scroll down to the Get FASTP section. Click the link of the binary file for Linux systems to download it. You'd create a folder named RNA-Seq Tools. Put the FASTP binary file in the folder. Go back to the Subio Platform's setting panel. Click the Choose button at the FASTP executable section, and select the file. Download the HISAT 22.1.0 binary file for Linux systems. Please be informed that version 2.2.0 does not work well for this. Unarchive the downloaded .zip file to extract a folder. Move the folder under the RNA-Seq Tools folder. Go back to the Subio Platform's setting panel. Click the Choose button at the HISAT2 executable section, and select the HISAT2 file. And click the link at the StringTie executable, the last one. Download the binary file for Linux systems. Unarchive the .gz and .tar sequentially to extract the folder. Move the extracted folder under the RNA-Seq Tools folder. Go back to the Subio Platform's setting panel. Click the Choose button at the StringTie executable section, and select the StringTie file. Click the link at the HISAT2 indexes section. And click the link at the genome of the GRCH38 version. It takes a while, so let it keep downloading. Go back to the Subio Platform Setting panel, and click the link at the GTF/GFF3 file section. Find the homo_sapiens folder and open it. Download the latest version of the GTF file from here. Unarchive the .gz file to extract the GTF file. You'd create a new folder named RNA-Seq Reference Data under an arbitrary directory. And then create the GTFs folder and the HISAT2 indexes folder. Move the GTF file that you extracted under the GTFs folder. Wait until the download of the HISAT2 indexes completes. Unarchive the .gz file. And then unarchive the .tar file to extract the folder. Move the extracted folder under the HISAT2 indexes folder. Go back to the Subio Platform Setting panel. Click the Choose button at the HISAT2 indexes section. Open the path RNA-Seq Reference Data, HISAT2 Indexes, GHCR38, and then select one of the HT2 files. Go back to the Subio Platform Setting panel. Set the path of the GTF file at GTF/GFF3 file section. That's all. Click the Save button. You see the execution panel. If you want to open the Settings panel, click the Settings button at the left bottom corner.